car in front of you. And that's the way it is with Lord. You got yourself lined up with the Lord. It's so easy to do.
That's right. Amen. That's right. Amen. That's good. That's right. We make it so hard. Mm-hmm. We make it so hard. We make this walk a hard walk. But just like you said, line it up. Mm-hmm. God don't ever leave us without instruction. Mm-hmm. He don't ever leave us without a way. Even if we don't even know how to navigate through the Word, we can tell God, I need that. And you be so sincere with God. Mm-hmm. And just tell him like I'm saying, God, now, this is what I need from you. And I don't know how to obtain it. Mm-hmm. But you know what I need. Mm-hmm. So whether if you can show me in here, let me see somebody, let me see it on the TV, God will show you through a commercial. Mm-hmm. He don't, it doesn't matter. Amen. If we sincere with God, amen. And just like she said, if we just look at that, look at him, God mm-hmm. is our mm-hmm. man. Just
lying
on in there.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Anybody else? Somebody else
had something. I was thinking that, you know, when I was trying to parallel park and I had the driver there person in with me, he said back here, I said, you know what? That's something my husband didn't teach me how to do. I laid it on somebody else instead of saying, how do you do this? Yeah. You know, mm-hmm. I want to lay it on somebody else. And I was listening today, this love channel, or whatever, I don't remember the name of the radio station, but it says, this man said, come on over to my church. I got an erasable Bible. Any way you want to live, you don't want to live this, or you can just erase that out and come out and do it. He said, you know, I don't want to go to this other church because they got hypocrites and they got sinners and they got sick. He said, come on my church. Ain't none of those there. So the man went on to his church and said, when he opened the door, well, nobody in there. He said, because ain't nobody in another church. that something's wrong with everybody. Mm-hmm. And you got to know this. There's no church going to be perfect.
Amen.
No church
amen.
Gonna be perfect. We all trying amen. To grow. Mm-hmm. We all trying to get to heaven. Amen. Some of us just said, don't rejoice in what was done. Just thank God that our name is written there.
That's right.
And try to improve ourselves, see things that we're doing. Amen. Don't compare to nobody, because that's what's wrong with us now. Amen. Well, she wears it, she gets all right, and she does it. Mm-hmm. No, but you don't know what she's going through right
amen.
Now.
Amen. That's right. That's
you,
right.
Know, you don't know what she's giving up.
That's
what
right.
you're going to start giving up.
That's
so
right.
The thing is, we want to stay true to Christ, not nobody
that's
else.
Right.
Stay true amen. To God. Amen. And you know what? You should have that little thing in the paper. Be true to yourself, and you won't play another man false.
That's
right.
true.
That's
because
right.
everybody
that's
knows right. who you are.
That's right. Mm-hmm. That's right. This goes so in depth. And y'all might know it different. I'll tell the short version of the man. He had his cross, and he was tired of carrying his own burden. He was tired. So he sent everybody else go to the pawn shop. So he took his cross, and he traded it in for another cross. He got to live in somebody else's cross and realize I should have kept the cross mm-hmm. that I had. Amen. Mm-hmm. So we have to be, like she said, we have to learn to carry our own burden.
That's right.
We have to learn to help people carry when they in a fault. Mm-hmm. And we have, as y'all said, we have the most perfect example. We have the Word of God. Amen.
Amen.
He's not asking us. I told it the other night. Those kids, the parents that take in foster parents, we're not asking them to fix the kids. You cannot mm-hmm. fix a kid.
That's right. Amen.
But if you just show them love, instruction, mm-hmm. and show them how a family's supposed to function,
amen.
That's what they amen. Haven't seen. Amen.
Amen.
If we can just show people again how to love, amen.
Amen.
If we can show people that there's still kind people in the world, amen.
Amen.
That will be more witnessing than you'll ever know. Amen. But sometimes we get so caught up. But I tell you, this is not a hard walk. It's never been hard. Amen. But it's just a matter of daily, you have to make a choice.
Amen.
You've got
that's
to
right.
choose
that's
to do right.
Right.
I'm going to be righteous means I'm choosing to do right. Like you
amen.
Said, Missionary Gamma, when evil's present, I'm going to choose
amen.
To do right.
Amen.
And every time I choose to do right, I'm getting closer
amen.
To my Savior. Every
right.
time. Amen.
Amen.
Jesus could have done anything he wanted to, but he knew that he was sent to do a job, and that's what he was going to do. It wasn't going people going to stir him to the left and the right. They wasn't going to provoke him. Amen.
Amen.
He was going to do for what he was called to do.
That's
amen.
Right. That's right. And if you teach a child, like you said, repairing, we can't repair them, but you know what? Just living right and
that's
teaching
right.
them right, they'll repair themselves.
That's
mm-hmm.
right.
They'll automatically correct themselves.
That's
they'll
right.
see it. Amen. I know sometimes with him, I won't give a switching. And I find if I talk to him, He understands what I say. Mm-hmm. And he'll start, and then he goes to do it, and then he thinks about it. They'll repair. Saints, we'll repair ourselves. Right. We know what's right. We'll start working on it.
That's right.
We'll start working on it. Look, this is a place we got to be. This is the plateau we have to be. And this is a daily walk.
That's right. Mm-hmm. It's a daily walk. Mm-hmm.
We learn. That's we right. Forgive. We forgive. We don't. We fall, but we get up.
We get back up.
And that's life. That's life. But don't give up. See, people have... Christian people are not taught this. That's the reason when they fall, they backslide all the way out of church.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Because they think, and we sitting in church, we're judging them. Well, they this, they know better and do this. No, sometimes they do get caught up.
Yeah.
If they have a habit, sometimes they do get caught up in that habit. Mm-hmm. And we've got to help them.
Mm-hmm. That's right. That's
this is a daily come
that's
on
right.
my hand, and we walk together. That's when I tell young people, when you get saved, stay around the saints. Because if you go back out there, it'll pull you back. But that doesn't mean I'm not going to go out there and try to save him. If he gets out
there
and gets tripped up, I'm going to try to still reach out for him.
That's right. And that's how we have to be. Speaking of Caleb, you know, sometimes he'll ask a question. You already know what I'm going to say. Caleb, he's like, can I get that on the TV? He said, and he only let me answer, so no problem. He makes that lip. He said, no problem. You're going to have to talk to Daddy. You're going to have to discuss it. And you're going to have good for her. He does a little lips. And I say that to say this. When we study the Word of God, the Holy Ghost talked to you. You're going to take a walk. He said, sure will. You see what I'm saying? So we just, like you said, if we just stay in it and build that Holy Ghost, we got everything in us. Amen? Mm-hmm. Just like that child does. He has everything in him. He knows what's what. He hears it enough. He can tell me exactly what I'm going to say to him. Mm-hmm. But he still does it. That's the same way with the Holy Ghost. Amen?
You know, because the devil's coming at us all the time.
That's right.
He don't want us to. He don't want us to make it, and he don't want to go installation service. And Sister Lord from Mount Carmel, she said something to me, and then she spoke, and then she said, "What is wrong with that Harry?" And off the top of my brain, it went straight to my husband. I said, "I'm gonna tell you that my two oldest granddaughters." Sister, tell them Chambers, I hate that name. And that's the way I said it to her. But God told me that then because I got on that phone and called her and apologized to her. She wasn't even talking about that hair.
Yeah.
She was talking about the landlord.
Yeah.
And that's how we can be so, you know, quick, you
that's
know,
right.
to go off.
Yeah.
You know?
And see, that's right there is a prime example where we need to be. Like you said, we have to humble. Because, you know, in the long run, when we humble ourselves and do what God said, he's going to bless you. And you'll receive a blessing that we don't even know about that you already received because of your obedience to that, to make that call. Because that takes you, it causes you to be humble. When anytime you got to go back, it's like I had to go back to that cashier and explain that. She was like, I didn't think that at all. Mm-hmm. Well, she probably did.
Mm-hmm.
But the fact of the matter is I had to go back and humble myself.
Mm-hmm.
My reward is greater. Listen, obedience is better than sacrifice.
Mm-hmm.
We're still trying to put sacrifice. God said, if you just obey me, mm-hmm. if you just make an attempt, listen, we don't always do everything that we ought to do and go where we're supposed to go that God tells us. But if my heart is right and I'm making an intention to go, God's going to bless my intention. I don't know how many Old Testament warriors didn't get to go. Now, all of them were disobedient. They just didn't get to see everything. But God rewarded them in that time because their intention was right.
Amen.
We cheat ourselves so much. But if we just stay humble before God, I feel the Holy Ghost right now. If we just stay humble before God, even if it looked like it's not changing, you adding up some things, and the more you sink, the more Christ rises, and when he rises, stuff begins to move on your behalf. Not only will it move, but he'll go before you. You get in your car headed to work, the Holy Ghost is on his way. Because you need to know, and I need to understand, that when we get in our car, even to do right, the enemy is looking to throw a dent, whatever he can throw in our path to destroy us, to keep us there. But God said, I'll go before you. Amen.
Amen.
I'm telling you, I should have hit that car like God, like that Holy Ghost spoke right in the middle.
Amen.
I'm telling you, that's how good a God we serve.
Amen.
When we're going to do good, amen.
Amen.
That's why a God is blessing him. Emmanuel got it, is he's saying, listen, make sure we stay humble.
That's right.
And listen, it's not haphazard. It's going to be folks that we know coming. We're going to know them.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And then we know that they've been in the ditch. Mm-hmm. We know what they've been doing. But God said it don't matter. Pastor said, leave the past in the past, because these are souls plus
right.
Y'all be lined up in here. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Continue to work. God going to bless you, man.
That's right.
Even
that's
more. Right. He's going to bless people to come in.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. We don't steal members. We don't steal members.
Amen.
But some members from some other places going to
yes,
come in.
Yes, they will.
I'm sorry. I hate to say it. They're going to leave one
Amen.
Team and join another.
Amen.
And when they come, we're going to love them
Amen.
And treat them right. And,
Amen.
God
Amen.
Said, I add to the church as I see fit.
Yes,
as he sees fit.
Amen.
Amen. Are y'all ready?
Yes.
Amen. We ready?
Amen.
God is getting us ready.
I say that, Co-Pastor, because I say some people are still looking for the word.
Yeah.
They still
Amen.
Looking for the word, and they not getting it other
place. You're right. You're right. They looking. There's still folks that's hungry and thirsty
Amen.
After righteousness.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
We just apply that for folks in this house and folks that are saved. But it's folks out there that's being called. They listen,
mm-hmm.
there's so many folks. You're not going to find too many folks in this world that has not had some kind of experience with God and church.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
That's right.
They can take you back to when Grandma
mm-hmm.
used to,
mm-hmm.
somebody said, I've been on drugs all my life. I was drugged to church.
Mm-hmm.
I was drugged to the choir rehearsal. I was drugged. Amen. We had a bunch of drug addicts in the house of God, but we was drugged everywhere
mm-hmm.
when we was little. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
But folks have been in church and they want that.
Mm-hmm.
They want that realness. I remember
Amen.
My grandma told me, and they was preaching that word. Amen.
Amen.
And God is pulling us back to that.
That's right.
But
That's
he's
right.
taking a lot of the stereotypes that we used to have.
Amen.
All the people. We have to stop all that stuff we're doing.
Yeah.
We're killing folks quicker than they get in here. We're killing them. Amen.
Amen.
And God is not calling us to do that. Amen.
Amen.
It says, let's look at verse 6. Let him that is taught in the word communicate unto him that teacheth all good things. Now, this verse, a lot of preachers and teachers use this means to pay your pastor. Amen. I'm just telling you. This is one of the scriptures they say. Yeah, amen. That means you need to give money to pastor because they, and you know that some of them got, they teach it. Y'all know how to smoke them. Sound really good. They start singing it to you. Oh, yes. Pastor can do it. Let us talk. Amen. But listen. What this is saying, and this is a good thing. It is, you got to relate scripture to the text.
Amen.
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 Now you can pull out, this is an example. And listen, there are other scriptures that say that we have we do give to people. That explains that.
Amen.
We're not, listen, we have guests come in that preach and preach. I mean, some, I mean, I'm going to tell you, I went, not because I seen it on TV, one man preached 23rd Psalm, so heavy, I was pulling money out of my purse, laid it on the altar. I'm telling you what, and I just do, and sometimes the word is just that strong. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's why, you know, when the speakers come, we give them offerings, just out, not out of formality. That's scripture. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
And Paul said to do so.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll get into that later. That's why we do that. We're not just paying folks just to be paying. Amen.
Amen.
We give them back an offering, amen, for travel, for eating expenses,
amen.
And if it wasn't in the Bible, that's just something we need to do, amen.
Mm-hmm.
It costs to ride down the road. It costs,
yes,
amen.
Yes.
I don't know about y'all, but y'all still use gasoline in your Hallelujah,
amen.
And so, but in this particular, let him that is taught in the word communicate unto him that teacheth in all good things. In other words, what it's saying, that as you pick up this person and you carry their burdens,
mm-hmm.
you that are you, you're humble. So we know that you're already mature in the word because you're humble, first of all. Anybody that's going to reach down and help somebody, he's already operating in meekness.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
So we know that they are mature saints. But he's saying that the one that has error is supposed to take that good teaching
mm-hmm.
and not only just hear it, but start doing it so that he can be reestablished or rejoined or reconnected back into the fold. Amen.
Amen.